That now, like when one thing is attached, there was a bit of a boat strike a couple of years ago, just after being gone out. It's a matter of interest, especially with children that do social studies and that. The real story about how, I'll tell you how Tin Can Bay really got its name. The early white men came here, there was big forests, and they wanted to remove all the trees, which they did. They removed all the trees in that Hawkes Forest. The last trunk of the tree is carved out the front there in the shape of a mermaid. So that was the last trunk. But this area is governed by three Aboriginal tribes. Anyway, the early white men happened to notice that there was a, you know, there was the dugong, there was for a creek as such, for an area. There was a lot of wildlife here. There were turtles, dugong, dolphins, and anyway, they asked the Aboriginal, what do you call this place? Because the name wasn't. There wasn't a known name for the area at that time. And the, I'm not as musical as an Aboriginal announcement, but the Aboriginal understood what the white man said. He said, Dunkinbar, Dunkinbar. So you might see the sign up somewhere, T-U-N, D-U-N-B-A, Dunkinbar, Dunkinbar. It's used on some motels and things like that. The white man thought he was saying Tin Can Bay.
I don't know.